start with new repository, new clinical repository. This repository is also a regional repository, which was published in 1873, April 1873. It is regional repository, means it is based on one particular part, one particular region of the body. So it is called as regional repository. This repository is contain only the symptoms related to eye. And the author give importance to clinical symptoms apart from the symptoms obtained from the proving, as that of Dr. Bell. As Dr. Bell, he gave importance to symptoms which he obtained from his 10 years experience. In the same way, Dr. Berridge, he also gave importance to clinical symptoms which are obtained from the he also gave the importance to clinical symptoms and the symptoms which are obtained from proving as well as from his clinical experience. So the full name of this Berridge's eye repository is Complete Repository to Eye by Dr. E.D. Berridge, who was MD homeopath. And it was published in April 1873. Number of pages in this repository are 317 pages are there, and number of drugs in this repository included about 1171 drugs in this repository, and it was published by BGen Publishers. So in this way, you should know the full name of Berridge's eye repository, because this is also asked for oral examination, that is, what is the full name of Berridge's eye repository. So you should know that its name is not only Berridge's eye repository, but its name is Complete Repository to Eye by Dr. E.D. Berridge. Then the Dr. Berridge, he was Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery from the University of London, then Doctor of Medicine from Homeopathic College of Pennsylvania, formerly resident medical officer to the Liverpool Homeopathic Dispensary. So this is the introduction of the author, that is, he is Bachelor of Medicine as well as Bachelor of Surgery from University of London. He completed his Doctor of Medicine from Homeopathic College of Pennsylvania, and formerly he became a resident medical officer to the Liverpool Homeopathic Dispensary. He is author of, he write down many other books. He is author of Index to Cases of Poisoning in the Allopathic Journals, as well as Pathogenetic Records. So these are his contributions to homeopathy, Dr. Berridge's contribution to homeopathy other than Berridge's eye repository, that is Index to Cases of Poisoning in the Allopathic Journal and Pathogenetic Record, as well as he also gave some other contributions to the homeopathy, that is in American Journal of Homeopathic Materia Medica, in North American Journal of Homeopathy, in Panamanian Monthly Journals, then Herring's Complete Materia Medica, Monthly Homeopathic Review, Great's Homeopathic Quarterly Journals, and British Journal of Homeopathy. So all in these journals, in these books, he gave his contribution while constructing or while he was practicing, he gave his contribution through these journals or these books. So which are the main source of this Berich's eye repertory? The main basis of this repertory is Constantine Hering's Materia Medica. He added some additional symptoms from later proceedings, valuable symptoms from cases of poisoning reported in the allopathic journals, which will in due time appear in the pathogenetic record. Now, being published as an appendix to the British Journal of Homeopathy. So these are the sources, different sources of this repertory. That is, the main source is Constantine Hering's Materia Medica. He take many rubrics, many symptoms from this Hering's Materia Medica and added some new symptoms which are not we found in the Hering's Materia Medica, because these symptoms are from later proceedings, and some valuable symptoms from cases of poisoning reported in the allopathic journals, which will in due time appear in the pathogenetic record. So now being published as an appendix to the British Journal of Homeopathy. These are the main sources of this Berich's eye repertory. The author in this repertory, the author, he gives importance to the clinical symptoms apart from the symptoms obtained from the proceedings. He gives importance to clinical symptoms as well as the symptoms which are obtained from the proceedings. The author feels that it is often difficult or impossible to decide from the proceeding alone what symptoms are really connected with each other, whereas if a group of symptoms is cured homeopathically, there can be no doubt of the necessary connection of its constituents element. Means, according to Dr. Berich, he in this repertory he included or he gave importance to clinical symptoms as well as the symptoms which are obtained from the proceeding. And according to him, it was difficult or impossible to decide from the proceeding that what symptoms are really connected with each other. Is there real connection between the two symptoms with each other? We cannot able to decide, or we cannot confirmly said that there is connection between these two symptoms. Whereas if the group of symptom is cured homeopathy, there can be no doubt of the necessary connection of its constituents elements. Means only through proving, only after proving, we cannot confidently, cannot able to say that this medicine can cure this type of symptoms and there is relation between or two symptoms, they are connected with each other, but only after when we give the medicine to the patient after clinical experience, when the patient get cured, when the group of symptoms get cured with that medicine related to that symptoms which we get in the proving, then we said that it is confirmed symptom of that remedy. So this was the concept of Dr. Behrisch. According to Dr. Behrisch, if we wish to obtain maximum benefit from homeopathy, we can only do so by faithfully following the three great rules of the master. How we can get a maximum benefit? We can get a maximum benefit after careful selection of simillimum, after giving a single remedy with minimum dose. So this was the advice which was given by Dr. Behrisch to all homeopath, that to get the maximum benefit, we have to follow our master's concept, Dr. Hahnemann's concept of prescribing, his advice of prescribing, that is, you should select the simillimum carefully. You should select the simillimum by after studying the whole person in proper way. Then use single remedy at a time with minimum dose. So when we follow such type of principles, rules which are given by our master Dr. Hahnemann, then only we get the maximum benefit from the homeopathy. We get, as well as our patient get, the benefit with the help of homeopathic medicines. So we should have to follow these three things while practicing. That means we should select the simillimum carefully, we should use single remedy at a time, and use minimum dose for prescribing. In this repertory, as in the previous Bell's diarrhea, which we discussed in previous lectures, that is, in that there are four gradations which are given to the remedies by Dr. Bell. In this repertory, the gradations are given to rubrics. In most of the repertories, we found that gradations are given to the medicines. But in this repertory, we found that there are five grades which are given to the rubrics. That means the grades are given to the symptom. In Bell's diarrhea also, some important symptoms, they are written in Italic, and other symptoms, they are written in Roman language. In this repertory, we found the five grades in five different type of typography, the rubrics are written. The first rubric is, the first grade rubric, or the most important rubric, they are written in Italic capital. Then the second grade rubric, they are written in plain capital. The third grade rubric, they are written in Italics. The fourth grade rubric, they are written in Roman letters. And the fifth grade rubrics, they are written in Roman in parentheses, that is in bracket. These are the doubtful symptoms in which are related to eye. So in this way, all the symptoms we found when we go through this repertory, Behrisch's eye repertory, we found that all the symptoms, they are written in different type of typography according to their importance. like Italic capital, plain capital, Italic, Roman, and Roman in parentheses. The above typography is used mainly in relation to rubrics and not to indicate the marks of medicine. So this you have to remember that in Perry's eye repertory there are 5 gradations which are given to rubric, not for medicines. And the medicines are written in 2 grades, either in Roman or Roman in parentheses. Means in simple typography, in simple language, in Roman letters, or the Roman letters which are written in parentheses. So in this way, the medicines which have written only in 2 type of typography, that is Roman and Roman in parentheses, and the rubrics, the symptoms, they are written in 5 type of typography that we have just discussed about. That, that is, the rubrics are written in Italic capital, plain capital, Italic, Roman, and Roman in parentheses, and the remedies are written in Roman as well as Roman in parentheses. The less important remedies, they are written in Roman in parentheses. Then ciphering. In this repertory, we found abbreviations to the medicines. At many places, we found abbreviations, or the medicines, they are written in short form. So with regard to abbreviations of the names of medicines, the author has adopted an uniform and scientific method of ciphering, as it is quite time that such absurd names as hypersulfuris, alcohol, sulfuris, and be discarded for more scientific nomenclature. The ciphers of the elements and simple halloid salts are the same as their chemical symbols. So how the medicines that are written in this repertory, it was given, the medicines written in this repertory, they are written with some abbreviations, and to write down the abbreviations, it was somewhat different. That is, the ATE salts are ciphered by adding only A, the ITE salts by adding I to the ciphers of the corresponding halloid salt, the IC acids are ciphered by adding X, the OUS acids adding IX, the hydracids by adding HX to the cipher of the element, or compound radical from which they are formed. So you remember this with examples better than by going through this slide, that how the salts that are ciphered by A, how the salts which is having ITE, they are ciphered by I. So we discuss examples of it. That is sodium, it was given as Na dot. Then sulfide of sodium, it was given as Na dash S. Then sulfate of sodium, it was given as Na dash Sa. Then sulfide of sodium, it was given as NaSi. Then sulfur, it was given as S dot. Sulfuric acid, it was given as S dash X dot, because acids are denoted by X. Then sulfurous acid, it was given in this repertory as SIX S-IX and sulfhydric acid was given in this laboratory as S-HX. In this way, there is in some different way the abbreviations are given in this laboratory, and these are the examples of those abbreviations, that is, for ATE salts we add A, for ITE salts we add in this laboratory it was added denoted by adding I. Then the IC, that is acids, it was ciphered by X. OUS acid, it was ciphered by IX. Hydracids by adding HX in this way, and these are the examples of all these things, that how different substances or different salts, they are salts, acid, they are, how they are ciphered, how they are abbreviated in this repertory by somewhat different way. In the medicines derived from the animal and vegetable kingdoms, each genus is invariably expressed by a different cipher. So, as it was from animal kingdom or vegetable kingdom, each genus, though it was animal or vegetable kingdom, it was expressed by different cipher. As for example, RS, Rustox, it was expressed, it was given in this repertory by RS. Then Rus glabrum, this was given in this repertory by RSG. Rus radicans, it was given in this repertory by RSR. Trigonocephalus lachesis, it was given in this repertory as TRG dot. Trigonocephalus atrox, it was given, or we found in this repertory, it has TRG dash A. Trigonocephalus contortix, it was found in this repertory as TRG dash C. In this way, the medicines are also expressed in different type of abbreviations or in different type of ciphers. The examples are given in this way. Then how this repertory was constructed? Perfect repertory should contain a reference to every symptom of the materia medica under every rubric where it can possibly be looked for. So when we said the repertory is complete, when we found there is reference of to every symptom of the materia medica, means where it was found and where we have to possibly look for to find out this symptom in materia medica. To effect this, he has divided each chapter of this repertory into sections. In the first section of each chapter, we found the symptoms and functions, and in the second chapter of this repertory, or second section of any chapter in this repertory, we found their conditions. So in any chapter there are two parts. In first part we found symptoms and functions, and in the second part of that chapter we found their conditions, including concomitant symptoms. In section first of any chapter, the first and second section of each chapter, they are arranged almost in the same way. The arrangement of section 1, that is symptom and function, and the arrangement of section 2, that is their conditions including concomitants, the arrangement of both of these are same, and how it was arranged we will discuss. In the section first, it is further divided into 5 subsections, that is functional symptom, anatomical region, general character, sequence and direction, then right side and left side. So in section 1, we found that there are 5 subsections of each chapter, that is the functional symptom, anatomical region, general character, sequence and direction, in then right side and left side. In this way, in each chapter, in first section, there are 5 subsections. Out of these 5 subsections, the first subsection is functional symptom. Objects, false appearance of, that is colors, far too, distorted, moving, multiplied, part visible. It was given in objects, false appearance of, then objects, imaginary. It was given in, after objects, false appearance of, objects, imaginary, it was given. Then photomania, after photomania, photophobia, then sight dazzled and sight impaired, that is blindness or dimness. So functional symptoms in the first subsection, it was given. All in this part or in this subsection, Dr. Berich tried to cover almost all the functional symptoms related to eye, that is objects, false appearance of, its color was not appeared properly, it was far too, distorted, moving, multiplied, part visible. So these are the false appearance of objects. Then objects imaginary, which are seen by patient, and the rubrics or symptoms related to objects imaginary that we found after the objects false appearance of. Then photomania, then photophobia, then sight dazzled and sight impaired, that is blindness, dimness. So in this way, the symptoms related to photomania, symptoms related to photophobia, symptoms related to sight dazzled, sight impaired, they are given in this sequence, in this order, in the first subsection, that is functional symptoms. Then the second subsection is anatomical regions. So in this second subsection, the symptoms related to each part of the eye, it was given, that is eyeball, sclerotic, cornea, chambers, means symptoms related to eyeball, first it was given, then sclerotic, then cornea, then chambers of eyes, iris, lens, fundus, orbit, orbital integuments, eyebrows, eyelids, puncta, lacrimalis, canthae, carincula, lacrimalis, then lacrimal gland, lacrimal bones, lacrimal sacs. In this way, all the symptoms related to these parts of the eye, they are given differently under each heading in this order in the second subsection of this first part, that is anatomical region. Then in third subsection we found the general character, sequence and direction. How the pain was, how the symptoms are, so the character of the symptom, sequence and its direction. If there is any direction, so it was also we found in this repository after the second subsection, that is general character, sequence and direction. It was periodical, gradual increase and decrease of the symptoms, then changing character or places, within, outward, without, inward, directions alternate with other organs or body. So general character and character sequence and direction, it was given in third subsection. Then the right side, in this fourth subsection, right side, general drugs affecting right side, it was given. In these functions, anatomical regions, it was given, which are related to right side of the eye or right eye. Then left side means the functions and anatomical regions of left eye, the drugs, general drugs affecting left eye related to their function, their anatomical regions, it was we found in the left side subsection. Then section 2. So as we discussed that in the first plan construction, that there are main two sections in each chapter. First is symptoms and function, and second is their conditions. So in symptoms and functions, there are five subsections, that is functional symptom, anatomical region, general character, right side and left side. Now we discuss about all these five subsections. Now the second section of each chapter, it contains aggravations and ameliorations. All the symptoms in these subsections are arranged alphabetically, excepting